And our world lead, President Biden, today putting the spotlight on U.S. efforts to help Ukraine, specifically on the weapons and supplies being sent overseas to assist Ukrainians in beating off the Russian invasion. But what is that doing to America's own defenses? CNN senior national security correspondent Alex Marquardt has a closer look at the impact on the U.S. stockpile.
The stunning success the much smaller Ukrainian military has had against the Russian invaders would not be possible without the billions of dollars worth of U.S. and NATO weapons flooding into Ukraine. Notably, the thousands of easy-to-use, highly portable American Javelins and Stingers that for more than 2 months have taken out countless Russian tanks and aircraft.
Sometimes we will speak softly and carry a large Javelin because we're sending a lot of those in as well.
So many, in fact, that now the U.S. inventory of Stingers and Javelins is running dangerously low.
The closet is bare. Just to give you one example, the United States military has probably dispensed about one-third of its Javelin anti-tank missiles to Ukraine.
While the U.S. wants to give Ukraine what it needs, Pentagon war planners must balance that with not letting supplies dip below what the U.S. needs.
I think we're at that moment now with Javelins and Stingers. The recent aid packages have not included any more of these missiles. To me, that indicates that the war planners have raised a flag here, and the civilian leadership doesn't want to exhaust these inventories further.
The Biden administration has just requested almost $5.5 billion from Congress to replenish its stocks. But the Pentagon insists the aid packages for Ukraine have not hurt overall U.S. readiness.
We will never go below our minimum requirement for our stockpile, so we will always maintain the capability to defend this country and support our interests.
1,400 Stingers, about a quarter of the inventory, experts and lawmakers say, has been committed to Ukraine. The Stingers manufacturer, Raytheon, which also makes the Javelin, says it no longer has some of the electronics parts, so the Stinger needs to be redesigned.
We have a very limited stock of material for Stinger production. We've been working with the DOD for the last couple of weeks. We're actively trying to resource some of the material.
The new phase of fighting in the flat and open eastern Donbas is changing the fight.
Fire!
The U.S. has just committed almost 100 howitzer systems and tens of thousands of artillery shells. But it's the Stingers and Javelins that have had the greatest impact. And now, according to manufacturers, getting back to pre-Ukraine inventory levels is going to take years.
I'm concerned because the production lines on these weapons have been marginalized. We weren't consuming them. Now we've suddenly given a lot of them, sold a lot of them away, and we need to get that production started.
There is no weapon more synonymous with this war in Ukraine than the Javelin. There's even been a Ukrainian song written about it, but they take around 3 years to be produced, and with so many going out the door to Ukraine, around 5,500 so far, with no end to the war in sight, and Ukraine asking for more, these production lines are really being tested.
All right, fascinating. Alex Marquardt, thank you so much.